Joyce, Tim, Sue.
Joyce, Tim, Sue, and Brian and Drew, and Clayton and Janice, and Ronnie and Candy. Mark and his wife Chris with their children. I think we kind of counted in total with family and out of town guests, it would be around 40 people, and that's not counting the people here at the church.
Well, we're going to take just a minute break. We're going to come back with you and Daryl, and
okay.
We're going to talk about work. To work, and then you know, how you guys met and marriage and that whole thing.
Okay,
so let's take
gotta be good.
Okay. Okay.
All right, we're back again. Same day, 50th anniversary day, and let's see. Let's start off with how did let me ask you. How did you guys first meet?
Well, we met, I was fairly good friends with her brother. We pal around a little bit together, and so I'd go down to his house, and once in a while I'd see her, and I'd try to attack her.
I knew this.
No, that's really how I met her, was really through her brother going down to her house. I mean, I'd seen her at school, you know, but... Anyway, that's how it all started.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen her down at her house and with her brother, and I finally, I guess, got up from there to ask her out or something.
Mm-hmm. So, did you knew who he was because of Mickey, or
mm-hmm.
do you remember the first time you saw him, or is it just kind of somebody that was kind of around for a while and then?
No, I remember when he first started running around with Mickey, and. I used to think he was so cute, but I thought he was so much older than I was because he was 2 years ahead of me in school, and at that time that was a lot, but he's really only a year older than I am.
Mm-hmm. I had hair back then, too.
So this would have been in high school, right,
mm-hmm.
when you met?
Mm-hmm.
What grades were you in at that time? You were a senior, or were you younger?
No, I was a sophomore or junior. Oh, well, we really met at was in summer school. We was in the same class as summer school.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know what I was in the 10th or 11th grade.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not really sure now.
So you've been 8th or 9th at the same time?
Yeah.
Because we met in summer school. Mm-hmm. Okay, in high school, I think we might have touched on high school early, but let's see, what... Now you played basketball. I remember seeing the short thing with you on the basketball thing. Tell me something about high school. Not just about the two of you, but just something, things you remember high school. What activities did you do or any other?
Oh, I remember the teen canteen. That was on Friday night or Saturday night, depending.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the time it was after the ball games,
that was like a youth club or something.
Yeah,
teen canteen.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's what they called it.
Mm-hmm.
They got together. They had music and they danced and they served refreshments. And, that was really the only place to go there in Fort Hall at that time.
So that was say like about 50. So what kind of music were they playing? You say dancing, but it was like slow dancing. Right, wasn't like
in round 50 it was mostly slow dancing.
Wasn't any jitterbug or anything like kind of.
Well, yeah, there was.
Oh, yeah.
That might have been just a little bit later, but
The late 40s and
yeah, like 49, 50,
somewhere around in there. That's
when did you all decide to get married? When do you remember the conversation or?
Wasn't a lot of conversation.
Mm-hmm.
I was at the corner pharmacy and he came by there and he said, well, he had just enlisted in the Air Force. And I was so mad at him. I could have just walked away then because I didn't think he ought to go. He didn't have to go. And But then we just decided that, you know, if he was going, he's going in the service and I finished school and, of course, that didn't work either. It was when he said he was going into service.
So, you guys got married in Maryland or something, is that right? Where did you get married?
Hagerstown, I think it was. Mm-hmm. But
I put Cumberland. I thought
Cumberland. Yeah, Cumberland, Maryland. That's right. That's Cumberland.
I think we didn't get married in Hagerstown because Daddy used to work there so much.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
We didn't want him to know. Mm-hmm.
So you, after this conversation, we said the drugstore or something like
mm-hmm.
that, then how much after that conversation did you went? Did you get in the car and go?
No, probably only a couple of days.
This is 50 years ago, I understand that.
Yeah. it was just like a couple of days.
Mm-hmm.
Because he was leaving on the 18th. We got married on the 15th.
Wow. So you went off to San Antonio.
I stayed home.
Okay. And then after you went to San Antonio and then Wichita Falls or something like that, and then you went to Biloxi?
Mississippi, yeah.
Yeah, and then I went to Biloxi.
That was after Cindy was born.
Mm-hmm.
Cindy and I went down and lived down there for a while.
Okay, well, that's a good one here. How about the birth of Cindy? Now, again, I know the other ones were kind of interesting over time, but these are like definitely all 50-year-old questions here. But so the birth of Cindy, what do you remember about that?
He was in the service. He was in Biloxi. So when Cindy was born, I had we just gave him a call. He was in service, so we gave him a call. But when you have your first child, you're really scared because you're not sure of what to expect, and then we were so young anyway, and she had a lot of problems, had a lot of problems delivering her, but when I saw her, even with all of her scratches and black eye and everything, I thought she was the most beautiful baby I'd ever seen. Never even noticed all of that.
Mm-hmm. And so when did you first see her? Was it, did you come back?
We came back in June, I think.
That must have been, yeah, I'm not sure.
That's when we went to Biloxi then.
Oh, you came back to Port Royal and all of you went down there?
Mm-hmm.
She was only three months old.
Uh-huh.
Okay, how about Tony? You remember anything about the birth of Tony?
Yes, I do. And I don't know whether you remember what you said or not when you found out you had a son. I did.
Tell us what he said.
I said we had a son that weighed 6 pounds and 13 ounces. And he went back to he was in line at the mess hall. And he went back and told him he had a 13-pound son. You don't remember
close
that.
Enough. Okay, we're back again. It's a day later. It's the 16th, and we've had a couple of, we had a big breakfast and a luncheon, and we're going back shortly here for a dinner to celebrate the 50th anniversary of these two folks here. Tell us your name.
My name is Gloria Patsy Walton Wall.
And your name?
My name is Darryl Jean Wall Jr.
All right.
Senior.
No, senior, that's right. Well, I tried to be a junior.
Sounded good, though.
I thought it was good.
Okay.
I guess a senior.
We have already talked about the birth of Cindy and the birth of Tony. And so if you want to tell us a little bit about the birth of Sandy.
Okay. Sandy was due on August 4th. But on July 12th, she decided she was ready. And we went to the hospital, very normal birth, very tiny baby, very weak child because she was so early, and she it was just forever before she would sit up even. And walk, she was 18 months old when my other children were 9 months old when they walked. We had to the doctor several times because we thought there was something wrong with her. But she's a very healthy young lady now and no problems at all.
You had a friend visiting when she was born?
Right, yeah. A gentleman I was in service with, Dean McBride, he was from Commerce, Oklahoma. We was together in the service. And, by the way, he was a friend of Mickey Mantle's. He grew up in the same town. It's just a little community in Oklahoma. But anyway, he rode a motorcycle, and he was making his last trip before he got married, so he come from Oklahoma to Virginia to see us. And of course, Patsy went to the hospital and had Sandy, and then, of course, he left and went up to Ed Rossman's up in Cleveland, Ohio, and Eleanor was pregnant. She was getting ready to have a baby, so he left there and went out to California, and he went back to Oklahoma, and then he got married, and he had about four children, and he got killed on the way home from work one evening in a car accident.
He decided he'd better get back home after both of us had babies.
Yeah. Okay, so we're in Front Royal. It's, Sandy was born 1956, 5 years after you all were married, and so there's a couple of years there after you got out of the Air Force that you were in Front Royal. What kind of work did you do there?
I worked at the Western Auto Store and also worked for an insurance company.
Yeah, Western Auto was down on Main Street down there.
Right, yeah.
And I worked for a credit bureau, Front Royal Credit Bureau, for a couple of years, and then I worked for a company for about a month, and I don't know what they did. I never knew what they did. They got boxes in and shipped boxes out, and I think it was illegal, so I got out of there.
Okay, so then from there, you moved to Akron, Ohio. And why did you move to Akron?
Front Royal was more of a tourist town, not a lot of jobs, and Akron happened to be a booming place at the time. We decided to go up. Daryl's parents were there, and his grandparents were close, and his uncle, and we decided we'd give that a try.
And where did you all work in Akron?
Well, I worked at insurance and also worked at First National Bank. Of course, worked at First National, and I left there and went with an insurance company, United Insurance Company of America, and that's when I worked there a short period of time, and then I transferred to Charlotte. January 1979, I guess it was. Yeah.
So that was what, like 58 when you moved there? 58?
Yeah, I'd say somewhere around there.
Cindy's?
It was over 20 years within Ohio.
Yeah, I think it was just about like a year after Sandy was born.
Right, yeah, it was over 20 years because we came here in 79.
And where did you work?
I worked for Polsky's Department Store, which is a big department store there in Akron. And I worked there for about, I'm not sure, about 3 or 4 years. And then I went to work for a company it was called National Rubber Machinery. And that's what we made, was the big machines that they made the tires and things from. And then later it was changed to NRM because we started making plastic machinery also. And I was there about 16 years, and I was a cashier for them.
How about the first, well, let's see, how many homes did, or how many different places did you stay when you were in Akron? Several or a couple? Or?
We first stayed with...
Well, it was three. We lived in an apartment there over where my mom and dad's house was. They had an apartment. We stayed up there. And then we moved up on Marcy Street. It was like a duplex. And then we bought a home out off Manchester Road. I don't know. We lived there the biggest part of the time. Mm-hmm. I don't know how many years we did live there.
Well, it must have been about 18 because Sandy started school out there.
Okay.
And she graduated.
It's been the biggest part of the time on Rexford Street.
Let's see. So from Akron, then you moved to Charlotte.
Mm-hmm.
And why did you decide to do that?
Well, we used to go to Myrtle Beach when we lived in Ojai, and we stopped in this area and stayed overnight a lot, and kind of liked the area, and of course we wanted to get out of the cold weather area up there, and this would seem like the right place, so that's when I went to that insurance company. They told me if I'd come there and work there a year that I could transfer wherever I wanted to go, and I told them I knew where I wanted to go was Charlotte. How we got here.
Hmm. And living in Charlotte, employment-wise, what did you all do?
I worked for United Insurance Company of America out of Chicago. They had, of course, they got offices all over the United States. I worked in the Charlotte office, and then I went up and worked out of the Shelby office, and then went to Rock Hill, South Carolina, and then I come back to the Charlotte office. So,
how long did you work for them here?
79 until you retired.
Yeah, 79 and retired. I don't know. So.
It must have been like 99 or 98. So close to 20 years, not quite, huh?
And I worked for a company that was just building their plant when I moved down here. It was Freightliner Corporation. They build the big tractors for the tractor trailers. And I went to work in the office because that's all I'd ever worked. And I found that they were making a lot more money in the plant. So I went out and worked in the electric shop, and I built the main cab harnesses, built the wiring harnesses for the cabs. Loved it. Should have been in the shop all the time, I guess.
And then she retired.
And then she retired. Doesn't do anything now.
Retired and
let's see, they retired 4 years, 97.
Yeah, because I've been retired 5 years this past January. Yeah. So yours about 4 and a half.
So what do you do in retirement?
Not much of anything. I play golf usually Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. And, then I have a friend up in Stanley. We do a little work on Monday and Wednesday and Friday. Sometimes we don't. We usually get out of the house for a while. We don't really do that much, but keeps me going.
Mm-hmm. Actually, what they do, they meet and have lunch, and then they have some, maybe a business, and then they have a stop for coffee, and then they may need to go shopping a while, and their business day is over.
Usually home by 3 or 4.
Sounds like a good deal here.
And I have nothing that's pushing me that I have to do, but I do a lot of work at the church. I love to play golf to start with, but I don't get to play that much anymore. But I visit the elderly, the shut-ins, and I do some work with the prayer ministry, and I
director of preschool Sunday school, and I love every bit of it.
So today we had a couple of big wing dings for the your anniversary, and like a lot of older pictures there. Did any particular picture come to mind that you maybe hadn't seen for a while or hadn't thought about for a while, or something that happened that just kind of came back to you today, or saw some person or any of that?
The picture that I love, and I hadn't seen it until they started gathering up these pictures, was one of Daryl and I at Betis, West Virginia, there at Aunt Lita's well, and Tony and Cindy were just little, and Sandy Ann was just, I'm just holding her in my arms. She probably wasn't over a month or so old, and it was just such a cute age for all three of the children, and great joy.
Okay. Before we end up here, I guess this is a wide open question, but
what's up?
I guess how does it feel to be married for 50 years? Yeah, let's start with that. How does it feel to be married for 50 years?
I'll take this one, honey.
Seem like 50.
Same
years.
Way as itself for 40 years.
Yeah.
Years.
Yeah, that's true.
That's true.
Not any different, and it's doesn't seem to possibly be 50 years. It's time went by so fast. We had good times and bad, but wonderful family and wonderful supporting parents, and made a lot of good friends over the years, and a lot of them we still stay in contact with. Just doesn't seem possible it could be 50 years.
Okay, well thank you all for the interview.
Thank you.
And we'll interview you again at 75.
There you go.